Good afternoon, friends and family. We're going to keep the casket open at this time while the service is going, as long as no one get up and start walking around to view. Amen. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Giving honor to God, who's the head of our lives. We are come together now to celebrate a life that is worth celebrating, the life of Wanda Kelly. And so we're going to get things started right away. And with this, with that being said, we're going to start with prayer and scripture from Melinda Kelly.
We're going to start first with our scripture coming from St. John chapter 14, verses 1 through 3. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye that believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I wouldn't have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go to prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you now in the name of Jesus. God, we come to reverence you, O God. We pray now that at this time that you would strengthen, O God, and comfort the family, O God, in the name of Jesus. God, that you would be the source of strength that they need to get through, that we need to get through this time, O God, in the name of Jesus. Even in the midnight hour, God, when there is no one around, God, let her begin to rest in you, O God, in the name of Jesus. Let love simulate from one to another, O God. In the name of Jesus, God, keep our children, oh God, in the name of Jesus, from day to day, oh God. In the name of Jesus, God, you be their strong tower, God, their leaning post, oh God. In the name of Jesus, God, let me give you glory and honor for it all. In Jesus' name, amen.
At this time, we're going to have a solo by Sydney Kelly.
Hello, I'll be singing Rise Up by Andre Day. Okay. You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out and move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise up, rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up high like the wave. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you. The silence is in quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe, and I know you feel like fighting, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet and move mountains. We'll take it to its feet and move mountains. And I'll rise up high like the day. I'll rise up. now rise up. I like the wave, I'll rise up. In spite of the ache, and I'll rise up. And I'll do it a thousand times again. For you.
Absolutely beautiful. Should have went first. Absolutely beautiful. At this time, we're going to have a poem by Terrence Bowden Jr.
How everybody doing today? A golden heart stopped beating. Hard-working hands at rest. It broke our hearts to see you go, but God only takes the best. They say memories are golden. Well, that may be true. The memories of you will be kept forever and cherished too. Your life was filled with love and labor. Your love for your family is true. You did the best for all of us. For that, we will always love you. Our lips cannot speak how we loved. Our hearts cannot tell what to say. But only God knows we miss you in our home today. Grandma, I will always love you. To infinity and beyond, and that's where my love will stay. Thank you.
The family of Miss Wanda Kelly would like to express our sincere appreciation for your prayers, calls, visits, and gracious support during our time of sadness. We thank you and we ask for your continued prayers. And at this time, we're going to open it up to remarks. We ask that you keep it to 2 minutes. We also want to invite those who are viewing from the other room at this time. If you have remarks, you're allowed to come over to this side.
Hello, everybody. I'm not a good speaker, but I just want to say I'm going to miss my sister. When I came in, I seen them pictures of her. She was so beautiful. I mean, always so beautiful. The diva, you know. She taught me how to wear a dress. She taught me how to dress. Put on makeup and told me my worth. Wanda taught me my worth. I really didn't know. She taught me so much. And you can see all the pictures and everything, how much she was loved and so happy. So happy. And this is an angel we're going to all miss. And the only thing I can say, God just comfort us all. We're missing her.
Good evening. Give it unto God who's ahead of my life. I've had the privilege of knowing Ms. Wanda for I think about 15 years now. And every time I seen y'all, every time I seen her, she's always had a bright smile on her face. She's been one of the nicest ladies that I've ever known. I've had the privilege of calling her mama because when me and my moms was going through it, Ms. Wanda was there for me. She always welcomed me in her home. She never passed judgment. I mean, she was just a well-rounded, cool lady. And I promise you, I'm going to miss y'all mama. I'm recently dealing with the loss of my mama, so I can tell y'all that it's going to be a hard one. I mean, all you can do is just pray about it. Both of y'all just pray. It's going to take time. And people love to say, you know, she's in a better place right now, which she is, but we miss our moms, and it's going to be hard. So to Sydney, Vic, Kelly, TJ, man, I'm there for y'all. Anything you need, just like let me know. For real.
I'm not a good speaker, but I've been knowing Wanda for over 47 years. Wanda took me in as a sister. We had a lot of good times together. Wanda understood me. I understood Wanda. Our paths crossed because her upbringing was exactly like mine's. Wanda was the sweetest person in the world. And she would always say, D, stop crying. Everybody know I'm a cry baby. D, stop crying. We gonna make it do what we gonna make it do what it do. We gonna make it do what it do. I love her. I love Bit. I love Bunny. I love her grandchildren. I love her sisters and her brothers. And we're going to get through this together. Y'all don't forget about me because I'm not going to forget about you all, please. Ooh, that's all I can say.
First of all, I'd like to give thanks to God for letting me wake up this morning. You know, this is very, very hard for me. Because while I was young, me and my sister was just like this. I mean, used to always be Steve and Wanda. And you know, what I really hated, as we got older, we just strayed away. You know what I'm saying? And I feel real bad. I mean, I really feel bad today because y'all really don't understand. But I love that woman right there. I mean, they used to do everything together. I remember we stayed on Kizzy and right off Madison. We had a big old ledge. We was little bitty kids. We walking across the ledge, me and my sister, following each other. We used to do everything together. But as I say, we got older. You know, with family issues, we just strayed apart. All I can say is to everybody in here right now, especially the younger ones, we just got to come together and stay together. And you know, we're like cousins, brothers and sisters mainly. Don't hold grudges for nothing. Because, man, that really tears people apart, tears family apart. I mean, we just got to start loving one another. Especially at the times it is right now today, it's rough. I mean, it's rough. You know, like I said, I love everybody in my family. Maybe they think I don't because I'm so distant. You know, we all have our own family now. And that's why it's kind of hard to, you know, like, be around everybody. But believe me, I love everybody in this room. I mean, you just don't know how much I do. Like, when I heard about my sister, I like, oh, God. You know, sometimes I don't know how to put it. You know, I hate I didn't go see my sister like the way I was supposed to. I really hate it. I mean, my family and I are just so distant. We just started to just come together because this is crazy. I mean, it's bad times out here, borrow times. We just got to start loving each other more and show that love. You know, call each other on the phone every now and then or something. You know. Once again, thank you. And I'm going to miss my sister.
Thank you to everyone that got up to share. As someone who only had the opportunity to meet Wanda one time, I can say that that one time left an impression. And just hearing what the family has to say, what close friends have to say, just in the amount of time that I got to spend a dinner with her, all those things, that those characteristics of being someone who carried themselves to the highest regard, being someone who loved everyone, being someone who lit up a room and filled a room with her presence, I got to experience that in just one encounter, and I'll never forget that. At this time, we're going to have the obituary read silently on your own. Actually, the obituary will be read by Tamika Kelly and LaWanda Kelly.
Wanda Letitia Kelly was born on February 17, 1961 in Chicago, Illinois, to the late Daisy Kelly and Sidney Reynolds. She was one of 13 children. Wanda was baptized at an early age at Metropolitan Church in Chicago, Illinois. She attended Dodge and Victor Herbert Elementary in addition to Richard T. Crane High School on Chicago's west side. Wanda gave birth to two daughters, LaWanda Shavante Kelly, given the nickname Bunny by Wanda's youngest sister, Melinda Kelly, and Tamika Danielle Kelly, nicknamed Little Bit, fittingly, as the youngest of her two daughters. Wanda dedicated her life as a single mother to raising her two daughters and providing a better life for that of herself as well as her girls. Throughout my mom's life, and as she confronted and conquered her own life challenges, adversaries, and tumultuous struggles, my mom vehemently instilled into us the importance of family and how important she demanded it be to each of them. Losing her own mother at a very young age ignited my mom to gradually come into her own and work to build a strong sense of self, one that her two daughters would learn from and ultimately be inspired by. It was through my mom's life experiences that she modeled to her daughters how to overcome obstacles and turn their fantasies into their realities. My mom committed herself to furthering her education. One of her proudest accomplishments was pursuing and obtaining her college degrees. My mom received her Associate of Arts in Early Childhood Education at Harry S. Truman in Chicago, Illinois, followed by her Bachelor's of Science in Early Childhood Education at Chicago State University, also in Chicago.
My mom's first employment was at Spiegel's in Chicago, Illinois, followed by Hall's Printing Company, also in Chicago. My mom began her career in the medical field in her mid-20s, where she worked as a certified nursing assistant at St. Agnes Healthcare and Central Plaza Residential Care, both in Chicago. My mom later transitioned into the employment field that would come to be her career passion, early childhood development. My mom gained employment as a teacher's assistant and later promoted to head teacher of her own classroom at Christopher House Uptown on the north side of Chicago, Illinois. My mom worked at Christopher House Uptown for nearly 18 years until she was unable to work due to long-term disability. This turn of event for Wanda was thought to be the fateful, as it intentionally signified the end of her career. However, it opened the door to what would be her greatest role yet. A loving and overly active grandmother to her three loving grandchildren, my son Terrence, my daughter Sydney, and Simone. I'm sorry, Sydney was named after my mom's father, Sydney Reynolds, and the youngest is my daughter, Simone. Wanda was pivotal in the everyday lives of her grandchildren by choice, which she was. She wouldn't have it no other way. She will move heaven and earth for all three of her grandchildren.
My mom's bout with her respiratory illness began to steadily decline in 2017. She was certainly a fighter. She fought undeniably hard until the day of March 23rd, 2020. On that morning at 8:39 a.m., less than 3 hours before she took her last strained breath on her own, she sent a text to both me and my sister, which read individually, "Hey, good morning. I hope you slept well. Everything is fine with me. What's up with you today? I was just thinking about just that." That was the inside we were talking about. "I'll text you later. #stronger. #stillirise. #irise up. #coming home. I love y'all too much, mama. Wanda." My mom peacefully entered her eternal rest on Monday, March 23rd, 2020, at RM Hill Hospital in Chicago, while surrounded by both me and my sister. Wanda was preceded in death by her mother, Daisy Kelly, her father, Sidney Reynolds, her sister, Yvette Kelly, and three brothers, Edward, Michael, and Don Kelly. Wanda leaves to cherish in her beloved memories her two daughters, LaWanda and Tamika, her three wonderful grandchildren, TJ, Sydney, and Simone, her four sisters, Teresa, Carol, Viola, and Melinda Kelly, and her two brothers, Steve and Major Kelly, and one honorary sister and very, very close friend, Donna Isabel, all of Chicago, and a host of nieces and nephews and other relatives and friends. Thank you.
As I was sitting over there, God just shared something that with me that I'm going to share with you that I hope is some solace in this moment. Sometimes you have to encourage yourself. Sometimes you have to speak victory during the test. And no matter how you feel, speak the word and you will be healed. Speak over yourself, encourage yourself in the Lord. Sometimes you have to speak a word over yourself. The pressure is all around you, but God is a present help. Well, the enemy created walls, but remember giants, they do fall. Speak over yourself, encourage yourself in the Lord. As I minister to you, I minister to myself. Life can hurt you so, till you feel there's nothing left. Oh, no matter how you feel, speak the word and you will be healed. Speak over yourself, encourage yourself in the Lord. And at this time, we're going to have words of encouragement by Melinda Kelly.
It's me again. I want to start by saying, like I always say, Wanda. We would be on the phone talking, she would just be talking and talking. I'm like, I want to get my point in. Wanda. And she'll say, okay, so what you got to say? So I would say what I had to say. But just to take a few minutes to expound about my sister, I have several memories of Wanda, but one memory that stick out with me kind of the most is when she taught me about preparation. You know, Wanda, when I was younger, she would put her makeup on. She loved putting her makeup on. And Wanda wouldn't leave the house until she was fully ready. Makeup, earrings, jewelry, outfit, dress to the nine. Am I right? So one day I was at Teresa's house, and Wanda went, I'm going to go to the mall. I'm like, okay, can I go? She said, yeah. So I got up, I got dressed real quick, and I'm trying on the spot, I'm ready to go. Wanda goes in the bathroom, I'm standing at the door, I'm looking. She put everything on the sink, laid it down just as nice. Okay, we're going to the mall, like today, you know. So Wanda started preparing us, and just put, you know, she cleaned her face and everything, and put all everything on, and I'm looking like, we're going to the mall. She was like, yeah. I said, you got to do all of that to go to the mall? She said, yeah, you got to get ready. You got to be ready. And I said, be ready? You just going to the mall. She says, one thing I'm going to tell you, never leave your house unprepared. Always walk out looking the best you can. I don't care where you're going. Be ready. So Wanda kept putting the makeup on, and I'm looking. You know, she had she was putting it on, so I was standing behind her, kind of looking behind me, beyond the mirror, so I could see my face and her face at the same time. So Wanda was putting the, she had this Maybelline eyeliner. Y'all know about that Maybelline eyeliner, right? You either run hot water on it or you take a lighter to it real quick so it can loosen up so you can, you know, put it on your eye. So Wanda had put an eyeliner on and everything, and then she put it down. I stayed on the side. I got the eyeliner too. And she cut her eye at me. So I did my eye. I'm standing there in the mirror, poked myself in the eye. Ow! She said, I did it a couple of times too. Keep on, you'll get it. So finally, by the time Wanda got through, an hour later, with the makeup, she said, okay, I'm ready to go. So Wanda looked at me in the mirror, looked at my face, and looked at her face. She bust up and started laughing. She said, you are hilarious. You are so funny. So I'm thinking I was looking good, you know what I'm saying? She had on her little purple, you know, whatever stuff on, highlight on. I'm doing the same thing. So I'm looking like a clown. She was looking flawless. So either way I go, I'm going to the mall. Me and Wanda leaves, we go to the mall. So we get to the mall. Hey, some people she knew from way back when we saw, she said, that's what I told you. Never leave the house if you ain't ready. Always be prepared. So when we got to the mall, some people were walking past. They'll look at her and look at me. They go, I'm like, why are they laughing? She said, you look like a clown. That's what I was trying to do what you did. She said, yeah, but you got to learn. You got to practice, right? So I said, okay. And another family about my sister, you know, Wanda loved her music. Y'all know Martha and the Vandellos, you know, Smokey Robinson, and, you know, a couple of her songs you listened to. So the other day I was listening to a little bit of music of Wanda's. And there's one song she would always play, One Less Bell to Answer. So, and then I said, why you listen to that song? I said, you'll learn, just keep growing. So one day I grew up, I learned the meaning to that song. But I want to say one thing about being prepared. 3 weeks, maybe 3 to 4 weeks ago, I was talking to my sister. And one thing about being prepared, my sister was prepared. She was making preparations for a while. And I was talking to her, and she said to me, she says, got always be ready. I said, okay. And we shared some things. And she said, Melinda, she said, remember I was talking about being prepared? I said, yeah. She said, I made a whole lot of changes. She said, I made some phone calls. And she called people. A lot of people got phone calls from her sister. And I talked to her, and she was making preparations. And that's why when I read John 14, said, I go prepare a place for you. Wanda went to a prepared place because she made herself prepared. She got ready to go to this place. And I'm working. I am still working to be prepared to get to this place where my sister is, you know, where she went. But in all the things my sister had did, man, my sister was the life. If y'all know my sister, she was the life of the party. Wanda come in, Wanda ready. And I always said I was going to be a comedian because Wanda just thought I was the funniest person in the world. I can come in the room and say, hey, Wanda, what's funny? Girl, you hilarious. I thought that was my name after a while. But I just thank God for the time that God gave me with my sister, for every smile, every laugh, every word. And like you say, when she tell you your worth, Wanda told me some things about my son, you know, being early childhood, you know, my son early on, little, you know, I didn't know my son is autistic. But she said, Melinda, do it this way, do it that way. I'm like, okay, I'm like, you just the expert, right? She said, well, if you listen to me, you know, you can get it done. And by my sister sharing with me how to do some things when Josh was early, small, to today, she taught me how to be a better mother to a son that I had. I worked with them kids every day, but behind my door, I had no clue. But she taught me how to be the mother I am to my son, to bring him up to be where he is today. And I know we're going to miss Wanda. We're going to miss my sister, you know, and the worries of her and my brother Don. Now we got to make it do what it do. Okay, like Steve said, love on each other, love one another. Let's not forget, don't walk from this place today and go weeks without talking to each other. Okay? You know me, I know you, and Wanda will always tell everybody to see me. That's my little sister. That's my little sister. So just in case y'all didn't know, I'm the little sister. All right? So family, be encouraged and know that Wanda loved everybody in this room. And if you didn't love Wanda, you wouldn't be here. So let this love continue to grow.
Can I have the people from the other chapel to come over to this side? This is our last review. Come on, y'all. Gonna go that way. The people in the back on that side, can you stand? Can I have the middle row to stand? This side. Go that way. Go toward the wall. Go toward the wall. The back wall. Did you all want to come around for viewing? No? Anybody else before I get to the front row?